So, some of those limiting beliefs are stubborn and deeply ingrained. And there's one of my favorite ones that even after doing a lot of transformational work, it keeps sneaking up on me again. It's like a spiral. It's not that nothing changed, but it just seems the more I open up, the more I dare to feel what I'm actually feeling, it feels as if sometimes it comes up even in a deeper way. So it's not always that things always get easier. And the capacity to hold everything, that increases over the years. So this favorite belief of mine is not being good enough, and I share this belief with very many, many, many people. And the result of that belief is that again and again, I effort too much in my life. I work too hard and I do too much. And so in me over the last few years, the longing to just have it be easy and to enjoy and to have fun increased. And then, and it happens a lot in my life now, but then occasionally when I take a new step or step it up or become more public or take a jump into something new, this old sock comes up again. So, and I notice it when I become more tense, when there's less joy, more efforting, and then there is this attempt to be good. And I'm good in being good. I very often, I'm a high achiever, I get things done, and I don't want to do it in this hardworking way anymore. So, if this video is not perfect and not 100% professional, then that's my new way of doing a good job. Okay, so this tapping sequence will be on letting go of the idea of needing to be good, because I would like to be fine without needing to be anybody special, without accomplishing anything extraordinary. And then of course, if things want to come through me and just happen, that's awesome, and I want to be very open for that too. But it's not that I have to earn my right to be here by accomplishing anything. So just as much as it is my right to be here just because I'm born and just because I'm here, that's your right too. So, ready to tap with me? Here we go. Even though I believe I need to be good for all these good reasons, and parts of me want to hold on to that, I have to be good, I love and accept myself. And even though I deeply believe that I have to be good, it's my way to stay safe, to be liked, and to remain in control, I deeply and profoundly love and accept myself, even though part of me wants to keep that belief. And even though part of me wants to keep the belief that I need to be good, I deeply and profoundly love and accept myself. Oh, there were some good stumbling phrases in there, so I guess I'm doing well, not doing perfect. Okay, so even though I've learned and I believe that I always need to be good, I deeply love and accept myself, and I open up to the possibility of making mistakes and still being okay. This old belief that I have to be good, this belief that I have to be good to be safe, this belief that I have to be good for people to like me and to remain safe, I let it go. I release and let go of this idea of needing to earn anything by being good. I release and let go of this idea that I have to be good, always and at all times. I allow myself to make mistakes. I allow myself to show up imperfect. I allow myself to enjoy my perfectly fine imperfection. I release and let go of needing to be perfect. I release and let go of needing to be good. And I choose to acknowledge that I'm just good enough. And for whoever that's not good enough, who cares? I release and let go of this need to be good at all times. I'm letting it go. I release and let go of needing to be good at all times. Oh gosh, I'm feeling already now, it's kind of a relief. It's really relieving to not put on that pressure. There's a dog walking by in the forest. This is the forest just around the corner of my house, and I love going here, talking to the trees, tapping. It's a great place to tap. There's always some place where you can tap in any situation, even in a business meeting. If need be, you could go to the restroom. All right. And then take a deep breath. Send everything that's already been moving down to the center of the earth. And another one. Okay. So there's much more we could do around this. This is just the beginning. And maybe even for you to just allow the idea in of possibly being okay while not being perfect and not getting it right, and maybe stumbling and falling occasionally, standing up again, dusting off. Maybe that's the beginning. So I invite you in being perfectly imperfect and enjoy the beauty of that. Thank you.